am by working as a roughneck on oil rigs, so some drilling rigs, and I live down there in Corpus Christi with my brother. And just the greatest guy in the world, the most affable guy in the world, always friendly. And one of my favorite stories, well, every great story about Dan Keene starts, Dan Keene was really drunk. So Dan Keene was really drunk, and he was really naked, and he's laid out on a concrete picnic bench right there in the city park in Corpus Christi, Texas. And they woke him up. And he said, hey, what are you guys doing? And he said, what are you doing, son? He says, ah, it's just on my way to my parents' house. Our parents lived 225 miles away in Houston, right? I said, oh, yeah, well, can you read this badge right here? He says, yeah, that looks like Corpus Christi Police. Hey, what are you guys doing in Houston? Yeah. He might have spent a little jail time there.
Christi Bay. I am a lover.
And his great old grandmother's lived out in Menard, Texas. I read a book about Menard, Texas, and then one of them, it was actually just a cowboy book, and they were traveling through Texas. But in the Menard, Texas chapter, it said at the very end of the chapter, at the end of the day, we came to Menard, Texas, surely the jumping off place of the world. And it was, but it was great for being kids, because, I mean, like, all there was out there was, like, she lived right next to, like, you know, the... It wasn't a Dairy Queen. It was just one of those, like, dairy whatever things. And so she lived right there. And it was so dry out there, you couldn't cut any grass. There wasn't any grass. There wasn't any work. And so it was all just about going over to the dairy, whatever it was, and chasing horny toads around all the time, right? And just so you didn't, like, get any blood in your eye when they spit at you. That was the only danger in Menard, Texas that I ever saw, you know? But it was very inspirational to be out there. And when she passed away, she left me this big painting of this guy on this horse and this little horse following behind. And I always loved that painting, so I wrote a song about it. And it was the first song, very first song anybody ever recorded of mine. And it was recorded by Reckless Kelly's dad, Muzzy Braun, right? Yeah. And he recorded it, said, thank you, I recorded your song. And a year later, he sent me a check for $50 for royalties. I said, man, I'm in the chips now. Hanging on the wall just like a thousand times you've been there. Picture of a field of dandelions and a young stud goat following some old cowboy on a brood mare bound to make it home by dinner time. There's a thunder at it coming from the west and east. You're thinking the rain will do this thirsty dirt some good, but it ain't a cowboy's weather, so he touches his old faithful and turns around to call out to the stud. Come on, Willie, there's a black cloud coming yonder. The devil beats his wife with a silver chain. Come on, Willie, boy, can't you hear the thunder? Your mom, you don't travel well in rain. It ain't nothing much to look at, just a friend I got from Grandma, a real West River cowgirl in her day. Sometimes I need religion since the old girl's gone before me. That's when I can hear the cowboys say. Come on, Willie, there's a black cloud coming under. The devil beats his wife with a silver chain. Come on, Willie, boy, can't you hear the thunder? Your mom, you know, drive well in rain. Come another sideshow, selling out good old days gone by. We never know it's raining, we can't hear it for our thunder, we can't see it for our firecrackers up in the sky.